Good morning, everyone. This is Jomar Hilario, and you are in the Marketing Your Business Big Time Using Books webinar. This is the first of a series of webinars devoted to explaining the world of book marketing using books as differentiated from book marketing. We are not here to teach you about book marketing, which is how to market a book. Instead, we're here to teach you, I am here to teach you about marketing a business who sells products and services in internet or offline, and using a book to make that happen. So this is the first of a series of these things. We will continuously do this until we end with a way for you to publish your own book, create your own book within 30 days. If you're interested in that, we're going to come up with a program like that. But this is just an intro. We'll give you an insight into this big world, this unknown world of book. Marketing books using marketing your business using books. So before I begin starting the lecture, I'm going to keep the lecture into 30 minutes, maybe just 30 minutes, so we can do some question and answer at the end. Okay, so I'm going to present you 7 ways you can use a book to make your business big. Okay, so please do type the words yes if you can hear me. If you have a question, just start typing them. Don't wait for the end point to type in your questions. As they come to you, just go in and type it in. So my personal background, by the way, my name is Jomar Hilario. And no, I am not an author. Yet, actually, I am, but you haven't seen the book. I have 2 manuscripts here under my desk. I still have to edit them in a big way. I have to rearrange some of the chapters. That's big, because I've already written the books. There are 2 books. But I do have a hand. I had a hand in building, listen to this, in building a business for Larry Gamboa, for Think Rich Pinoy. He made the book, but the business was made after the book was made. The Think Rich Pinoy business was done. And believe it or not, we would stage events, you know, live 2,000 peso, 3,000 peso events. On the basis of the fact that there are books in the bookstore, we did only online marketing and the books in the bookstore. That's it. And we just connected the books and to the people who would read them, and then invited 100 people every 3 months to attend the seminar. Pretty good start for just the presence of the book in the bookstore. No other kinds of advertisement was done aside from online, which is, and online we were not promoting the book. We were promoting the seminar. When I say we, it was me and my assistant. I hired a out-of-school youth to do the marketing online. That's one background. And the big background I've got is every time Bo Sanchez would create a book, some of you probably know him. We say, yes, I know him, if you know him. Starting with The 7 Secrets of the Truly Rich. Yeah, starting with that book, I was already with Bo promoting all his books since after that. I actually named one of his books. It's the book on I forgot. Hindi siya ganun ka bestseller. It's one of his low best-selling books. It's about addiction. The book is about addiction. Kaya medyo hindi masyadong best-selling. I actually named that book. Okay? So, trivia lang yun. If you see a picture of me and Bo Sanchez in the internet, na may hawak akong computer, that was the time that I named that book. Okay, I think that's the 7 secrets to true freedom, but actually it was about addiction. Okay, that's that book. But okay, so every time Bo would create a book, I would always be behind him in the internet promoting that book. Okay, so that's a lot of that. Most of his books are bestsellers with my assistance. Okay. So, yun po lang, and some other smaller authors that you probably never heard of. Okay, so that's my background. I do online marketing, believe it or not, for fun. I also do it as part of my help for Bo Sanchez. And my primary thing is not to teach people how to become authors, but to teach people how to do online marketing, to do it so that they can earn from home. Okay, my secondary market would be to help businesses promote their products and services online. not by selling their products and services, but by marketing. And the big difference is when you market, you try to create a relationship first with possible buyers, okay? And then you sell, okay, later. Then you sell later, okay? So that's my short introduction to myself. I'm going to go straight into my mini talk on book marketing. I hope you don't mind if my intro is short, because that's how I do it, okay? Okay, just a moment. By the way, I'm in the Philippines, and yes, I'm in Manila. Let's do this. Okay. First thing you need to understand is I'm going to give you three words, and you're going to tell me exactly what the three words are, because you know. Oh, here are the three words. What comes to your mind when I say Thrones, Potter, and Twilight? I would imagine you're thinking of the Seat of the King and the guy who creates pots, and of course the time of day, nag-aagaw dilim. But no, you're not thinking of chairs and pots and the sun or the moon. You're not. And this is our personal introduction. This is our personal life when it comes to books. We think, okay, that books are just that. They become movies. But even with that internet, okay, America today, right, they buy 57 books a second. That's 5 million books a day. Even with the internet, there is the America, at least them, you know, they buy 5 million books a day. And that's a lot of books. Even if you thought books are dead, they're not. Okay. So let me continue. So can books mean more than blockbuster movies? Apparently, yes, because you only know 3 best-selling books who's become movies, probably total of 15 movies, so probably total of 15 books. But what happened? How many books are sold? 5 million books are sold every day in the U.S. alone. So there's a lot more books out there than blockbuster movie. Okay? So here's a quiz. This is a very difficult exam. What is this? What do you see? This is a trick question. What do you see? What does this remind you of, this thing? I'm going to give you 10 seconds to figure out the answer. Okay, wrong answer. This is not Starbucks. This is actually the cover of Howard Schultz's book called Onward, How Starbucks Fought for Its Life Without Losing Its Soul. So the entire talk is taking advice from the CEO, founder of Starbucks. And he made this book. Actually, this is probably like, he already has 3 books, I think, on Starbucks and his life in Starbucks. And believe it or not, this book has endeared. Can you figure out the Tagalog version of endeared? Napamahal. Napamahal si Howard Schultz sa mga, believe it or not, business people, managers, company owners. Why? Because this book helped them understand how Starbucks started, ended, continued, almost failed, and lived as a company. And believe it or not, well, alam niyo naman eh. The company owners, the entrepreneurs, the managers, the employees, these are the guys who buy Starbucks. And what is the, do you think it's accidental that you're reading a book on Starbucks, you're not going to buy Starbucks on a regular basis? Of course you will. You'll try to go inside the store and find out what does the book say about it. It's okay if you don't know. This is a best-selling book. It's a best-selling business book. So Howard Schultz is telling us something. But let's assume you don't believe that. Let's go to Google. And in Google, you look for top 10 business books. You're going to find some old books like Think and Grow Rich by the dead Napoleon Hill, because, yes, he is dead. And some books by Ogmund Dino, okay, who is also dead, the greatest salesman in the world. But that's not our point. The top 10 business books, according to Google as of today, contains Good to Great by Jim Collins. That's the book on the left, the pink one. And goodness gracious, another book by Jim Collins, Built to Last. Do you know what he's selling there? Do you know what Jim Collins is selling? I won't answer. You'll find out later. How about The Lean Startup by Eric Ries, who he tells a story about how to create a new company. Do you know what he's selling there? How about The Blue Ocean Strategy, which is a completely boring, hardbound book read by almost all the managers of many businesses several years ago. What was he selling there? Okay, let's go to the next page, which is more books. Who Moved My Cheese? What was he selling there? And here is a reflection of the same thing that Howard did, Howard Schultz of Starbucks. Tony Tsai, this is the book called Delivering Happiness, the second book, created the book called Delivering. Tony Tsai is the CEO, founder of Zappos. They sell books. And by the way, Zappos.com is exactly the company na ginagaya ng Lazada.com. I know you know Lazada, right? So Zappos.com is a store that sells shoes sa America. And it was made popular because of its culture. And its culture was we hire people because they need to be a little... We only hire people who are a little bit crazy. Ayan, yung sinabi ko na sa inyo. Yan yung kanilang popularity. Guess how that popularity of that company got cemented into the minds of business people around the world who, by the way, have the capacity to buy shoes from their website. The book. The book, Delivering Happiness, told the story of what happens inside Zappos. What happens inside the lives of the employees, how they offer people to resign by paying them $5,000. All those things can be said in yung parang, yung word of mouth. But this book told what happened inside Zappos, yung Delivering Happiness. And guess what? I've never purchased from Zappos, but I bought that book, and I went to the Zappos website, and yes, I talked to the customer service. Do you know why? Here's a chance for you to understand how this works. The book made me go to the website. You know why? The book said, if you go to our website, Zappos.com, and talk to our customer service personnel, you can talk to them about anything, and they will answer you nicely, and they will talk to you like a human being. Why don't you test it now? I don't know if they are still like that. But when I did go to Zappos.com, because of that book, nakipag-usap ako sa isang Filipino na empleyado nila. Tagal namin nag-usap. I think 30 minutes. I didn't buy anything. And I went there because of the book. Now, let's move forward and show you the fifth discipline. Do you know what that book was selling? How about Seth Godin's The Dip? How about Getting Things Done? How about Michael Porter's Competitive Strategy? These books and the books before it, they were selling something, actually. And let me just answer my question. Para hindi na kayo nababaliw dyan. Here it is. The first set, Jim Collins, Good to Great, Built to Last. It sold Jim Collins as an expert. It sold Jim Collins as a consultant. If you have a book or several books, well edited. By the way, you're looking for ideas on how to execute properly this book thing, make sure it's edited heavily. You have zero mistakes, next to zero mistakes in English grammar. You have to get hire an editor to do it for you. Don't mess around with editing. It's one of the reasons why people abandon books. There is an entire science of book abandonment, and one of the biggest things about bad books is they're poorly edited. So, alam niyo. Ngayon, The Lean Startup, Eric Ries is now an expert, recognized experts in startups. The Blue Ocean Strategy enabled the company owners, the people who wrote this to become consultants for that Blue Ocean Strategy. You need to pay them to do a Blue Ocean Strategy seminar in your company. And that's the same with Who Moved My Cheese. There's also a seminar called Who Moved My Cheese. Yes, they were selling a seminar eventually. I don't know if they were selling it before they created the book. It doesn't matter. The important thing is it did help sell something. Okay, the next one would be, the next set is Zappos, you already know, is selling a shoe store. The fifth discipline is a seminar in the company. Seth Godin sells his ideas in all his books, and he becomes a recognized speaker and keynotes and consultant and investor. Getting Things Done sells a system of how to be more productive. It's a book. It's a poster. Believe it or not, Getting Things Done sells posters. The posters are not cheap. Okay, they are not cheap. Yung lalagay sa dingding, they sell posters. They sell DVDs, CDs, all those things. This Getting Things Done book, big business yan. All because of one book that you can get. I've mentioned Getting Things Done in the past. That book, you just read the first five chapters, solve ka na. You read the other chapters next year. First five chapters pa lang ng Getting Things Done, pwede ka na mabuhay. And then they have many products under the banner of Getting Things Done. And they use the book to promote. Okay, so let me proceed to the next part. You got questions? Go ahead, questions. I don't know anything personally, okay? I don't know anything personally about Howard Schultz's background when he created the book. Because when I started working, okay, Starbucks was just beginning to pick up in the Philippines. And I already saw that book. I already saw that book. It became a big hit already. Starbucks was not yet that popular in the Philippines. It was it had a few stores in Manila pa lang. I already saw that book. So just to be clear, don't know anything about that book on Starbucks because I didn't read it. Yeah, I didn't read it. I did read Getting Things Done, the Zappos book, and all the other books there. Okay, but Starbucks is already mainstream, but even became bigger. Okay, so let me go to the next part. Here is the last of the set of books I'm showing to you. I'm showing this to you because there are two books by the same author, and that's what. Seth Godin, all marketers tell stories, and Seth Godin's the dip. Seth Godin's funny because he doesn't have a company. He's selling his ideas, and that's exactly what anybody here can do. You don't have any products. You don't have a service, but you got ideas, and that's what he does. Seth Godin has a long background in internet marketing. He actually founded a website called Squidoo, yung parang squid, parang octopus, Squidoo, and he earns a lot of money from that. And because of his experience in early online marketing and his talkativeness, his ideas are just blog posts. I'm not kidding. His ideas are mostly blog posts edited to become a book. And that's it. That's what he does, and he's one of the more well-recognized marketing guys on the planet. No product except himself and his ideas. So there you have it. Books can be used to promote seminars, posters, literal shoe companies, a coffee shop, nothing, promote the author, no? Essentially anything, book, you can create books. So books, from this point of view, answers the question, can books be more than here are my thoughts? Because, yeah, Seth Godin does it. These are his thoughts. But the other books, no, these are not our thoughts. These are our stories. This is how we grew the company. This is how we failed. This is how we should approach things today. Yung katulad ng Blue Ocean Strategy. That book is just about this idea. This is how you should approach your business. That's it. And it's not even a well written book. I mean, it's so hard to read. I'm so sorry. I'm so used to Bo Sanchez books. So easy to read. The Blue Ocean Strategy, I think I gave away that book kasi sobrang hirap intindihin. And the only thing that they were trying to say in that book was, you should create a market that nobody else is in. Yun lang ibig sabihin nun. Yun lang sabihin ng Blue Ocean Strategy. Have you seen an ocean? Yeah, okay. Have you seen a blue ocean? Yeah. All they're saying is, create your own ocean and be the only fish in that ocean. Parang ganun. In my case, if you want an example, Blue Ocean strategy is train people to become virtual assistants. That's my ocean. Nobody else in the Philippines was doing it in when I started. Ako lang yung gumagawa. So that's my ocean. Okay? So there. Also, this ocean of books, who's teaching you how to make books online? Probably ako lang. So this is my ocean again. So yeah. So let's continue. So why should you market using books? So even if I already try answer that, I'm gonna give you my 7 pointers and how powerful book marketing using books is. Okay. The first one. Can you type the word one so it's fun? You know, if at least I know I'm talking to somebody. First reason why you should use a book is because you will have an advertisement in all the bookstores in the world. Before you say no because you're thinking of National Bookstore and Fully Book, that's not what I mean. When you create a book, it suddenly, because of formatting, you know, run your book through a format, sometimes there are apps that can actually format your book for you. You suddenly appear in the Kindle store. What's the Kindle store? It's the largest bookstore, one of the largest bookstores on the planet, and it's accessible by internet. It's the Kindle Amazon store. And Kindle is actually, ang alam nyo, Kindle is, it's an ebook store. Actually, yes, it's an ebook store, but it's connected to the Amazon bookstore, which is the biggest bookstore on the planet, actually. So you can have a digital version of your book, and you can have a physical version on your book on the Amazon bookstore. Those are two bookstores already that are worldwide, and people can buy your book. And I'm saying this not because people will buy your book, but because this is an advertisement. When people start looking for your topic, your business, you have a picture of your business there, like Howard Schultz. Right? A picture of your business. Like that. That one. He used the logo of Starbucks. And that's an ad. That's an ad that appears and people see it, and you don't have to pay anybody to put it there because it's essentially an advertisement. Now, the second bookstore would be the massive iTunes bookstore, which is applicable for iPad, iPhone, iPad mini, Macintosh. The iTunes bookstore appears in all Macintosh computers, appears in all the iDevices, and it's one of the most massive bookstores on the planet. Just because you have a book, you can appear here. These are all, you know, Marvel, that's a brand, and your brand can appear there. And all you needed to do was pay a graphic artist to create a cover and put a bookstore books there. Now, Jomar, does it mean the book has to be read? No. They have to see the cover first. And when people see the cover, they are reminded of your message. And a lot of traditional marketers, this is valuable because if you are reminded of the message of the company, there will come a time you will remember that. Okay? So, bookstore presence, very, very, very important, because the only way to buy bookstore presence is to actually have a book, at least a book cover. Right? Now, Jomar, does being in these bookstores, does it mean the books have to be 100 pages, 300 pages, 2,000 pages? No. 35 pages, as long as you have a cover, you got a book. So I'm going to expand my definition now of book to include ebooks, because believe it or not, ebooks are growing, and so are books. Physical books are growing, ebooks are even growing faster. And there is really, it's actually even easier to make ebooks than to make a physical book. Right? So, as long as you have the graphic artist make the cover and you have the right formatting of the book, even if the editing is bad, you can submit it to the bookstores on the internet and you can just revise it as you go. Let me repeat, you can revise it as you go. You can revise it for free. You can change the ebook and improve it. Even the cover, you can change it without cost. When you change it, the only cost is how much are you paying the editor, how much you're paying the graphic guy. That's it. Versus a physical book, wherein you have to really do printing before you change anything. The faster you move on this thing, the better, because your presence in the bookstores are very, very straightforwardly easy. Straightforward meaning register, pay the fees, very minimal fees, and then upload. Upload the book, upload the cover, put in the blurb, the short description, put in the back, in the picture of the back. As simple as that. Okay, next. People who haven't read of your product or service can hear about it from the best source. Do you know who the best source is? This is number two. Can you type number two? People who haven't read, heard about your product or service can hear about it from the best source. Now, of course, you want them to hear it from the best source, and that best source would be you, ikaw. Ikaw ang best source. And here's one thing you need to understand. When they hear about it from your ebook, they didn't just hear a sentence. They heard 35 pages worth of information from you, at least if you made a 35-page ebook. Right? And here's the psychology of it. If a person devotes 30 minutes of his time reading about your company, there's a bigger chance that he will buy from you in the future versus a person who saw a picture of your advertisement in Facebook. Kasi there's no devotion of time. But what if your book is longer? 100 pages. That guy is going to spend 2 weeks reading your book. He's going to spend 2 weeks of his day being reminded of your service, your product, your story. When I say story, how you failed in your business, how you succeeded in your business and all that stuff. To the point that you become a household name to that person. And if they need help in that topic, let's say your topic is about efficiency of using the car. That's the book, because you're actually selling something as simple as gasoline. I'm not kidding. Really, I'm not kidding. You're selling something as simple and basic as gasoline. And then you write about car efficiency. And then in the book, you keep mentioning the, you know, Shell, let's say you're working for Shell this, Shell that, or a local company that most people have not heard of, there's a big likelihood that they will remember you and talk about you at home. You become a household name to the readers of the book. And they're not going to go to another brand if they have invested so much time with your brand. Unless, of course, your product's really bad. Okay, so you become the go-to person, the acknowledged expert, because you are the best source of that information. So there's a how question. Okay? The how question is answered by secondary. This is not for everyone, but this is for people who are leaders in their business, and that's public speaking. Public speaking happens automatically when you are a book writer or an author. Can everybody type the word three author? Type the word three author or three, I'm an author. Now, a writer and an author, those are two different things. A writer writes for magazines, for DWK and all that stuff. I'm a writer. Yeah, I've been a writer for a long time. I write for a blog. Now, an author, that's a different shark. That's a different whale. That's a different dinosaur. That's a different creature altogether. Authors have high risk, have a high perceived respect that once you get a book out on a certain topic, you instantly get invitations to public speaking. How? People will start asking you, hey, can you do a speech? And let me tell you the easy way to do that is just to create a summary of your book after you've created the book or before you've created the book, and then that's your speech. Hey, I'm not kidding. They're going to ask you to TV guest if they're looking for somebody to talk about that topic. Let's say your topic is about crochet. Okay, fine. You're selling expensive bags, so your book is about lifestyle of expensive of high class people. I mean, you don't know these people; you just research them on the internet. You made a book, and then if they're gonna talk about high class, they're gonna ask the internet. Okay, They're gonna look for popular people online, or they're gonna go to a bookstore. They're gonna look for books on that topic, and if you are an author, the respect goes way up. But if these guys have a TV show, if they have a radio show, they're going to invite you to talk. Now, don't be too excited. The impact of TV guesting and radio guesting is not as big as you think it is, but it's a big deal because we grew up on TV. Well, all of us grew up on TV. So we think it's a big deal. Actually, internet is more important than is more stronger than TV or radio, but okay, fine. You're in heaven because they've invited you. You can go on radio tours, whether you do it, call them up, or they invite you. Book signing, it's automatic. If you have a publisher, you're going to have to come up with a gimmick in the bookstore for book signing. Book tours is when you go to multiple bookstores to talk about your book or to read a part of your book. It's actually normal for authors to read their book for 30 minutes to their fans. It's normal, believe it or not. It's normal. You think that's not a very valuable thing, but to fans, that's a big thing. Seminar guesting, so if somebody wants to create a summit or, you know, a big event with multiple speakers, most of the time you will be taken as a speaker if you have a book, because the perception of authors is you're an expert because you wrote the book, literally. And panels is you don't get to do a speech, you get to answer questions from the audience as a member of a panel. And these things will open up almost immediately once you start marketing your book and letting people know that you are the person talking about that topic. When I say topic, I mean that topic that revolves around your subject, which is your product. Okay, you have a spa, you have a massage place, so your book is not going to be about spa directly. It can be about reward lifestyle, or it can be about Zen or finding peace. You know, then you just so happen to have a massage place that you can go to. Okay, so if you're a business pro owner, please do write down in the comments your business so I can use it as an example. So the how, you do public speaking. If you're not into public speaking, then you're not going to be in the public. You are going to be what? A webinar or podcast guest. You don't show yourself to the public. They do hear your voice, or they do see your image online. Para mag-guest ka ng mga vloggers and video bloggers and podcasters. So that's pretty automatic if you have the book, and the book subject is something that the show owner, the podcast owner, the TV owner, the TV show owner or producer, or the radio show owner. Pareho kayo ng topic. Or it's the topic that you have in your book is something that they can relate to, then go. Tuloy yan. Makukuha ka nila as guest. Okay, next. The value of the autograph line. Now, this is a world wherein we are not really familiar. Imagine your business. Meron kayong lechon business. Imagine may pila sa labas. Maganda ba yun? May pila sa labas dun sa sporting good mo. Tapos tomorrow punta ka, may pila na naman. So this is my vision for you. No? May business ka, may pila na naman. Okay. Hi, Myrna. She's in Zamboanga. Okay, meron kang, nagbibenta ka ng middle to high price jewelry sa isang stall sa mall. May pila. May pila. Di ba maganda yun? May pila. And that's actually the version for all authors, okay, is the autograph line. Now, the autograph line doesn't exist so that people will get autograph. Alam niyo ba yun? The autograph line, it exists so people can have one-on-one time to talk for 1 minute with the author. And that 1 minute can be, kaya maganda yung line, kaya may value yan. Ikaw ba naghihintay o sila? Sila. Ikaw ba nakatayo o sila? Sila. Ikaw naghihintay ka lang, the next person. And what you're doing is this very high efficiency of talking face-to-face with a lot of people. And this is what happens to Bo after each feast, di ba? Pag nandiyan si Bo, tas wala na namang feast after that. Uupo siya sa harap, tas pipila ng napakahaba ng tao. And that way, he gets direct feedback from people, what books they like. What did he say that he like? What did he say that they did not like. And that value of getting face-to-face ear time, nakikinig siya sa mga tao, is so valuable in forming the next books, so valuable in forming the next talk, so valuable in giving the next seminar or the next topic sa feast. It forms a very, very good listening ear sa business person. Ang problema kasi na maraming business person, sila lang ang boss, sila lang ang bida, sila ang Superman. The best way for a business person to adjust, sa, lalo na sa ngayon, Facebook is going down, retail sales are going down, you're trying to get sales from the internet, the easiest way to overcome the limitations ng mga yon is to start listening really good sa mga clients mo para you know what they see you. Let me repeat that. The autograph line allows you to find out how people see you because you don't know that. When I say you, I mean your business, I mean you as the author. And it's very simple if you do it the way Dan Kennedy does a book, that every chapter points to the last page of the book. And what is contained in the last page of the book? An invitation to avail of something for free, an invitation to buy at a discount, an invitation to visit the store. Do I need to repeat that? I will repeat that. If you do your book like Dan Kennedy does his book, Dan Kennedy, Marketing Guru, every chapter will point the reader to go to the last page of the book. Scattered throughout, the last page is an invitation to buy something at a discount, get something for free from the internet. You know, yung tinatawag nilang bonus chapters. But actually, you wrote that as part of the book. Tinanggal mo lang. Kaya siya naging bonus. And it allows people to act after they read the book or while reading the book. So you grow your email list that way. And I'm not going to tell you the second value of the autograph line. You feel good. You get to sell your products directly to human beings who are standing in line waiting for you. And then they're going to be happy when you sell to them because they're your fans. That's a big value. And you become an author, you get introduced to this world of the autograph line. Grabe. You go to the next part, which is, sabi ni Stephen King, when you're a writer, people will take you seriously. Iba na eh. Iba na yung tingin sa'yo, iba na yung tingin sa business mo. The credibility shoots up if that's missing from your business. May credibility ka pero konti lang. Credibility will continuously shoot up. And this is underlined by the story by Stephen King. By the way, Stephen King is a horror novel writer, but he's radically best-selling sa America at around the world. So I used this story from him. Once upon a time, Stephen King was invited by Bruce Springsteen. Si Bruce Springsteen, siya yung One Direction ngayon. Okay? Sikat na sikat siya. Rock and roll. Para siyang Beatles time. Sikat na sikat siya nung 80s. So Stephen King was invited by Bruce Springsteen to have a meal. Kumain lang sila sa labas. So kumakain si Stephen King. He was younger then. At who's a author, and see Bruce Springsteen, a rock and roll superstar. So in comes this 16-year-old girl na mukhang merong okasyon, parang birthday niya ata. But pretty, young, tapos she was feeling very special. Una sabi ni Stephen King, the girl looked like it was really her special day. The girl immediately saw them and went straight to them, both of them. Pangalang artista. Sino yung lalaki? Kalimutan ko yung artista. Yung rock star started getting his ball pen from his pocket. Okay? Si Bruce Springsteen. Started getting his ball pen, anticipating the autograph. The girl went straight to Stephen King and said, "Hi, you're Stephen King, right? I love all your books. I read all of them. Can I have your autograph, please?" Which leads us to the next part. Authors are rock stars. Okay. When you become an author, you're not just the acknowledged experts. People start behaving, lalo na yung readers mo, they start behaving like you're a rock star. And you know what rock stars do, no? Rock stars, they bring in the audience. They bring in the audience. And in your case, if you're a business business person, they bring in the buyers. Naghahanap ka rin celebrity. Why don't you just be the celebrity by writing the book about the story of the business, the story of the failure, and you become the rock star? And people associate your name with the book, unless you use the same name. And then people start buying from you. This is what rock stars do. They drive people to buy. Diba? Kaya nga may concert. Pagkatapos ng concert, anong ginagawa ng fans? Bibili ng swag. Swag are the t-shirts, the CDs, the DVDs, the special editions, the posters, the notebooks. And that's it. You might not like to be a rock star, but if there's a rock star in your company, gusto mo siyang gawing rock star, it will drive the audience. It will bring in people. That's why a lot of companies spend for celebrities. And I'm disappointed to find out, I had a conversation kanina with a big, big company from Italy, that using celebrities, not that great. Even if they were anim na celebrities and they're really, really popular, not that great pala. It's still about the message. It's still about, hindi lang basta celebrity sila, they will bring in people. Now, but if you're the author, the kind of people you drive in are not deluded. They've actually read your book. Meron substance. May substance yung pagiging fan nila sa'yo. Hindi lang, ang gwapo mo kaya ka fan. Alam mo yun? So there's a better reason for them to buy whatever you say. Because they have a deeper relationship with you based on the number of pages of your book. Okay, so there. So, Rockstars actually has this other benefit. Is if you're a rock star in your industry because of the book, you become doors open to access markets you didn't even imagine existed. For example, you get invited to Malacanang. That's what happens to Bo. You get invited to exclusive clubs that you don't know existed to talk to that club. You get invited to reach far off places supported by non-government organizations na hindi mo alam pwede pala. Alam mo ganun? You get invited to Asian Development Bank to speak to their expats because of you. You have a topic that they really want more details about. Gusto nila ng empowerment. You wrote in your story how you empowered your employees in the lowest time and they needed an empowerment speaker. Ganun. Your story, I'm talking about a book that has a lot of stories, ha? We're not talking about concepts parang textbook style. The books that I've shown you in the top bestsellers, they are concept, story, story, story. Concept, story, story, story. Ganun ang format ng mga books na yun. Okay. So, let's go to the next one. Second to the last. Number 6. Book readers have their own social networks and influencers. Probably not well known by now that there are massive amounts of people reading books, which is automatic, they're not going to talk about it in Facebook. They do it in Goodreads. I'm a member of 2 large social networks on books. I forgot the name of the other one, but the other one is Goodreads. Can you tell me Shelfari? Shelfari was purchased by Amazon. So it's now Amazon Shelfari, and Goodreads yung kalaban nila. Goodreads is actually a massive website full of book readers and book lovers. And guess what? What do they talk about? Books? What is the way to gain influence in a social network like Goodreads? Have a book. Have a book. Okay, next. Let me show you some more about Goodreads. See? You put in your book, you rate the books, you review books, you say the books you've read before, you create a list of books you want to read, you look for recommendations by human beings on the books, and you see who are the most read authors, you see who are your counterparts, your competition, all those things you normally don't do inside Facebook or Twitter or Pinterest or Instagram. These are a social network of books. Now, let me show you the value of Goodreads. Where is this article coming from? Who is covering Goodreads in 2012? These are the top 25 book reviewers on Goodreads. Why would they cover that? And who covers it? Forbes magazine. Forbes magazine. About 2 years ago, they're already looking at Goodreads as a place of, by the way, top 25 book reviewers, these are called influencers. If you had a relationship with these 25 human beings, you have a book. Okay, I'm gonna tell you straight. Go to Goodreads. Look for the top 25 reviewers today. Friend them in Facebook, in Goodreads. Talk to them like a person. Talk to them. Listen. Talk like a person. Once you finish your book, they're going to be so excited to review it. Yes or no? Yes. And once you launch that book, 25 of the top reviewers on the planet, that's essentially it, on the planet, will be reviewing your book. And these are unknown people. These are not media people. These are not famous personalities. These are just people who love to write 4,000 reviews on Goodreads. I'm not kidding. Ganun karaming reviews ang nilaride nila. And all you need to do is befriend them now. I'm telling you exactly how Tim Ferriss did his book. You tell them now that you want to be your friend, befriend them, listen to them, give them information that they need, be a human being. And then when you launch a book, you'll have instant international exposure in Goodreads from the top 25 reviewers. It's as simple as that. Hindi pa sikat internationally, well, in the world, in the outside world, itong mga reviewers na to. Some of them, they come in first name lang. Hindi ko pa alam yung real name nila. Point here is, that's technique, and that's been done by big authors like Tim Ferriss. Befriend the influencers a year before you write your book. And I'm pretty sure none of you is going to write their book in 2 days, right? So I can do that. So that's a big, big strategy for you to, or tip for you to follow if you're serious about creating that book. Okay, number 7. Very important. Books give you the excuse to collect readers' emails. Because once you create a book, here's what happens. You go to the bookstore. They don't buy it. They go to the internet and look for the review. That's what happens. They see a book. They don't buy it. They read reviews first. And once they find the review, make sure the review exists in your website also. So they're already in your website, then you can ask for their emails. And as I said in many, many, many situations before, nothing has replaced email addresses in internet marketing. You still need to get people's emails, kung influencer emails, yan, yes. Kung buyer emails, yan, yes. Kung prospect emails, yan, yes. But if you have a book, people will search for you online, look at your website, and then kasi hindi nila hanapin ikaw kung wala kang book eh. Maghahanap sila ng generic terms. But if you have a book, they're gonna be curious what the book is about. You're gonna create a website or a Facebook na may reviews ng book. They're gonna read that. While they're reading it, you're gonna outcome will just pop up and then they're gonna enter their email addresses. And this is the backbone of online marketing. You get their email address. So it gives you an excuse, no? Because they're not really looking for your solution. They're looking for you. They're looking for your book. And now you got their email. Now you can sell to them, or you can serve them, or send them 3 chapters, like what we did with the 7 Habits of the Truly Rich. We gave the introduction away. We gave the first chapter away. I think we gave the preface away. And we gave 3 chapters and then launched yung book ni Bona, 7 Habits of the Truly Rich. I think we gave 3 chapters before we told people to buy ng book na yan. And an insider lang yan for those na hindi na experience yung launch ng 7 Secrets of the Truly Rich book. Okay? So, those are the 7 things. Let me just review it for you. Wala akong review slides. I'm just going to go reverse. First thing is, you have an ad in all the bookstores in the world, the big ones that matter. People who haven't heard of your service can hear about it from the best stores. You get instantly introduced to the world of public speaking, even if it's just audio, because of your book. You will gain access to the valuable autograph line, which is just like a client line. And you can be a rock star if you want to. Number six, you will have the excuse to be present in the massive social networks of book readers on the planet. Essentially, increasing your reach to online. Okay. And number seven would be to enable you to collect email addresses, not based on your product or service, but based on the book, or based on you as a human being, as an author. Okay. So that's it. That's my short presentation today. Hindi ako umabot sa aking deadline. It took 1 hour to say all those things to you guys. If you guys have questions, I'm all ears. Yes, it's not, that's all we can cover in an hour, but I did give you a lot of things. I hope you magamit nyo yan. My question for everyone, if you don't have a question, would be, how about you? Are you ready to write your first book? So your answer is yes, no. Ganun. Lalo na yung mga business persons yan. Like si Mirna, si Champrix from Cagayan de Oro, si Mirna from Zamboanga, si Kath, si... Sino ba may business? Si Rosemary, si Carla. You guys ready to write your first book? The first thing you need to do is to determine the topic. And that topic is usually done by listening. Usually by not writing about your product and service, but listening to what people do before they buy. What situation are people in before they buy your product? Normally, yun ang topic ng book mo. Okay? If nahihirapan ka doon, you just tell the story of how you formed the company, and that's good enough. Really. Just tell the story of how you formed the company and how you failed, and that's good enough to start you off on your first book. Anyone? So somebody's asking how much is online marketing webinar. I don't understand the question. This is a free webinar, and the recording of this will also be free. I won't be selling this webinar. This is going to be free. If you're looking for my mentoring program, the mentoring program that I do, it's in jhilari.com/online-mentoring-3. So this is the program I do for pure online. Show ko lang sa inyo to answer this question. Pure online, I teach you guys how to do online marketing. Not necessarily books lang, to promote anything on the internet. So this is how I teach beginners. This is for beginners, right? For entrepreneurs, the program I have is different. It's called the Marketing Success Formula. This is designed for you guys to jumpstart your internet marketing. This is a 12-month program also, katulad ng kanina. Pero this has live meetings sa Manila. So you have to go to Manila or at least access the recordings. And you will have to follow with our workshop. It's a 3-hour workshop every month and a 5-hour live meeting every month for 12 months. And the result is we will practically create your online presence in 12 months, practically. Right now in the Marketing Success Formula, we are writing our first ebook. We are in the 2 more webinars, tapos sulat na yung ebook. We're not after number of pages. Madaling pahabain ng ebook. Ang importante is it written in a way that it talks about the situation of people before they buy from you. Ayun. If you create a book like that, that's gonna be good. And if you have a book and it's in the flash drive, you send it to an editor, okay? Because you totally need somebody to look at the book seriously. Okay? Look for an editor in Fiverr.com. Fiverr, I think. Fiverr.com. Kita mo naman yung comment kung magaling siya o hindi. But you need to pay people to edit your book. The topic is either your success story, paano mo na-form yung company, that always works, or you use the situation before people buy your product, service. You talk about that. You talk about that. Ba, nagbibenta ka ng ano, nagbibenta ka ng kotse. So, you talk about the situation of people, the life of the person deciding to buy a car and why, yung story niya, bakit, why do you want to buy a car? Or, ba, ang business mo, signage. Ano ba yung mundo ng tao na bumibili lagi ng signage? Signage, yung mga karatula. Ano ba klaseng tao yan? Is that a business person? Do businesses buy many signage? Or do government buy many signage? So should you make a book about the problems of people inside the government? Hindi to make, hindi negative. Addressing the problems inside. Kasi ganun yun. Whoever is buying from you the most, the best buyers, you create a book for them. Hindi for your company, for them. And the book, ang focus niya is the situations and the problems that arise and the solutions before they buy the book, before they buy the product. Ganun. So a very simple example of that would be a guide to selecting your college for the kids, for your kids. So, yeah, halimbawa, it's printed by Ateneo, pero ang title pa rin ganito, How to Select the Best College for Your Kids. It's very biased, but people will not care if it's biased, if it's well-written. Yeah. So, gets yun, ganun lang yun. So, how to select, yun yung kwento. And you're gonna fail if you just keep say giving concepts. You have to keep telling stories. Ha? These are books. How do you think of a unique selling proposition for your book? Hindi mo, you don't need to hurry up on the USP for your book. What you need to understand first is what I just said. What would be the situations that people find themselves in before they buy your product? If you don't have a product, then it could be any topic. It's wala kang product. Whatever you like. Okay? If you don't already have a product, think of the situation where they need help in, that you can write a book around. Right? Decision making, then it would be better for the for Jessica if you give me the what are you selling? Jill, books kasi are good for marketing because they as long as people exist, books will exist. Eh. So, they never tire in marketing you. Pag nawala ng kuryente, may libro pa rin eh. Nawala sa internet, may libro pa rin. So, as long as there are shelves and there are books, the books continuously market you even they are purchased sa bahay. Because the bookshelves are like marketing shelves. So, you can promote in the bookstore, you can promote at home. So, win-win and books get swapped. Diba? So, win-win ka talaga. So big deal talaga yan in marketing niya. Normally, Jessica, USP is achieved by creating the correct title and subtitle, pero based on research. What are people really looking for in desire? Good night, Belle. Sana daw internet cafe nila eh. Overtime kasi ako ng 1 minute. Ganun. If you're attempting to write a book but can't, you need to go use Jay McLean's style. Get a partner in writing your book and tapos ka. Tapos na yung libro, I mean. If you're not an expert and you don't have a business, write your success story. Well, ang sabi ng success story dapat may failure ah. Kasi weird ang success story na walang failure. It's boring. So, it has to have a story. As a failure. If you don't have any successes, then write the first failure book. Pero actually, hindi ka first. The first failure book na binasa ko, which is really good, is called Failing Forward by John Maxwell. Guess what? It's full of failing stories. Failure stories. Secondly,
if you don't have anything to say, be the interviewer. Like, sino yan? Yung famous interviewer of all? Think and Grow Rich. Just interview people who've failed more than you have. And you
be on your way to writing your book very quickly. Interview. Si Marianne Mencias, I met her dun sa best-selling authors bootcamp ni Bo, where I spoke also. I spoke on book marketing in the best-selling authors bootcamp. I saw her book in the bookstore, and it's about his interviews with say, Marichan and stuff like that. And because of that book, she has gone so many places, interviews here and there, public appearances, book signing, invitation, nag siyang SM something something, ano yung Schumart? Parang recognized female leader because of that book. She's reached out to a lot of authors also. And that book was about, that book's an interview book. It's stories of other people. So, I forgot the title of her book, pero kilala ko siya. So, yun. Big deal talaga yung getting a book published and becoming an author. So, in your lifetime, do goal to be an author. Can you type that in before we say goodbye? I'll be an author. Type nyo, I'll be an author, Joe. Yeah. Cool. So, thank you for attending this 1 hour webinar on book marketing a business through books. I hope I was able to reach out into your mind and be inspired to enter this new world of being an author. Before the year is over, I will be publishing 3 books. Yeah, no, wala akong may deadline ako. The next book has to be done within a few months from now. The 2 books are already here with me. So, edit na lang, which is not my task, somebody else's task. And then, book cover, and then book design. Book title, that's it. You know? When it comes to, tanong ni Jill, if you decide to write an ebook and not a physical one, does editing certain parts entail coming out with the new edition? No. Oh, well, no. Just edit the book. That's it. Just edit. You don't have to say anything. Just edit the book. You don't have to revise the title or say the second edition. You can if you want, but you don't have to. Right? So, thank you so much for joining the webinar. You picked up on some things. I dropped some stuff to me. It's valuable. I hope you picked it up. Moving forward, there's a lot more on book writing what we will be discussing. I will leave you with a quote again from Stephen King, and he says, "Writing is magic. It's free, like the water of life. So drink, drink, and be filled up." That's a quote from Stephen King. Thank you so much for joining the webinar. My vision for you is you will entertain becoming an author, and you will start opening your world, you know, opening your world into this new world of being an author and book writing. And last question from Jessica. "I'm in Singapore. Is it advisable to publish a printed book or ebook?" Always go for ebook first so you can test it. You can change the cover, title, anything. Once you get a winning formula, ebook form, you can print it. Almost guaranteed ang sales mo. Because believe it or not, after they buy the ebook, they will want the printed book. Do you know why? Hindi mo pwedeng pa-autograph ang ebook. So thank you so much for joining, guys. See you next Monday. I forgot the topic, but I'll be announcing the topic for the webinar. Recording will be up immediately. Thank you so much. I'm out. See you on Monday, 9 p.m.